Hey, what is going on, guys? My name is Mike, and welcome to a little segment called Let's Talk Hockey. Hey, what's going on, guys? Alright, no, fuck. Alright. Hello, and welcome to a little, fuck. Big splash day in the NHL. Dion Phaneuf traded to the Ottawa Senators. All that. Fuck, like. Let's Talk Hockey, Episode 1. So, Dion Phaneuf just got traded to the Ottawa Senators. And Phaneuf was rumored to go to a lot of teams, but, you know, nobody knew if he was going to be traded yet. So Dion Phaneuf was rumored to go to a lot of teams around the NHL. A lot of teams were interested in him. A lot of teams wanted him for the playoff run. And Toronto was obviously looking to get rid of that $7 million contract that Phaneuf is holding on the Leafs. Especially that, you know, Toronto's not going to be making a playoff run in the next couple of years. So they really want to get rid of him. Okay. So Phaneuf had a contract going through the 2020-2021 season. And it was $7 million. Along with Dion Phaneuf, the Maple Leafs traded away Matt Fradden, Casey Bailey, and Ryan Rupert. Along with another defenseman. The Maple Leafs, however, received Jared Cowan, Milan Mikhailiuk, Colin Greening, and Tobias Lindbergh, along with a second round pick in the next year's draft, which is the 2017 NHL draft. Dion Phaneuf has 24 points in 51 games. Dion Phaneuf has 24 points in 51 games for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Obviously, they're not a high-scoring machine right now, so he's not going to be racking up those points as he usually would. Dion Phaneuf only has 24 points. Phaneuf only has 24 points in 51 games, and Toronto's obviously not like that big scoring machine, so he's obviously not racking up the points that he could or he should. Now, with this $7 million out of this cap, can the Maple Leafs sign a high-rated sniper that's about to go on to the free agent? Now, with this huge contract out of the way for the Maple Leafs, they have a lot of room to sign a free agent, maybe. A free agent that's, you know, going to be at the end of this year. Possibly a sniper who used to play for Tampa Bay. Or, I don't know, he could still... Fuck, that's stupid. Damn it. Now with that huge contract out of the way, Toronto has a chance to, you know, sign some players during the offseason. One player that comes to mind, Steven Stamkos, obviously. Even though right now, as this video is being made, his contract is still undetermined, and he might not be traded by the end of this year. He can go into free agency at the end of this year and not be able to discuss a contract with the Tampa Bay Lightning. However, back to Toronto and Ottawa. With the Ottawa Senators having only 28 games remaining and tied, not even for a playoff spot, but tied with the Montreal Canadiens with 56 points. The Ottawa Senators only have 56 points right now, and with only like 30 games remaining, they are tied with the Canadiens. And now, with the Canadiens doing so poorly, especially with Carey Price, their MVP, the MVP of the whole NHL, he's out with an injury still. Can the Ottawa Senators make a playoff run and try to hop over? Thank you. Okay. Fucking Miss Licklider. Of course I can make it. Go away. Alright. Damn it, lost my train of thought. Alright, okay. Now, with the Montreal Canadiens playing so poorly and Ottawa Senators, you know, trying to, you know, maybe make that run again like they did last year, especially with the carry of Andrew Hammond, but this year it's going to be Craig Anderson. He's back and healthy. Can the Ottawa Senators possibly hop over the Montreal Canadiens, especially with Carey Price injured, their MVP? The MVP of the whole league is injured. And Ottawa, not Ottawa, fuck. With the Montreal Canadiens playing so poorly, and with Carey Price injured, can the Ottawa Senators make that historic playoff run and run to the playoffs themselves, just like they did last year, especially with this acquisition of Dion Phaneuf? Okay, and now with Dion Phaneuf off the market, you know, a lot of teams are looking for that nice defenseman to definitely boost their team up and definitely boost them for the playoffs, you know? I shouldn't say, you know. With Dion Phaneuf off the market currently, now only a few defensemen remain as, you know, good offensive threats or even just good defensemen themselves to help a team win the playoffs, you know, and win the Stanley Cup. One of them is Dustin Byfuglien, and he currently just signed an extension with Winnipeg and will no longer be, you know, trade bait, you know, for any other team. Two other defensemen come to mind. Keith Yandel of the New York Rangers. Alright, I shouldn't do that. Two other defensemen come to mind. Keith Yandel of the New York Rangers and Kevin Shattenkirk of the St. Louis Blues. Shattenkirk would become an unrestricted free agent at the end of the 2016-2017 season. Whereas Keith Yandel, he will be a free agent at the end of this year, the 2016 season. In 53 games played, Keith Yandel only has 40. Oh, wow, no, I read that wrong. In 53 games played, Keith Yandel has 28 points. In 45, Kevin Shattenkirk has... In 45 games played, Kevin Shattenkirk only has 27 points. These two players are great offensive players, and I don't believe, you know, they could be traded. They could, might not be traded, especially Keith Yandel. The New York Rangers are definitely making a look, The New York Rangers are definitely looking to make a playoff run once again this year, and Keith Yandel is a big part of that. Last year, they got Keith Yandel in a trade to help, hopefully, you know, boost their playoff hopes last year. But unfortunately, that ended in the Eastern Conference Final against Tampa Bay. This year, they're just looking to make an even bigger run, and with Keith Yandel and his contract, ending at the end of this year, you know, will they trade him? Will they try to get something for him to bring it in to help win the cup or to help make another playoff run? Or will they, you know, believe in Keith Yandel and try to make that push to the playoffs and the push to the cup with Keith Yandel or not? You know, you never know. So guys, thanks for watching. That was basically Let's Talk Hockey. There's going to be much more of that. And I'm basically a Ranger fan. I am a Ranger fan. I shouldn't say I'm basically. I mean, what the fuck? Okay. I'm a really big Ranger fan, so I'm going to make a lot of videos about the Rangers. Definitely be a little biased, of course. But yeah, so thanks for watching, guys. See you later. Subscribe for more hockey videos. There's going to be a lot more hockey videos on the channel. And yeah, thanks for watching.